Do you want more listings? I've got four reasons that you can reach out to more potential sellers next on Agent Hacks. We are in the middle of a listing and inventory crisis. There is a shortage of homes on the market, and not only is it a problem for the consumers, it's also an issue for agents because we know that when you list, you last. When you list, you can take that listing and leverage it into another couple pieces of business if you're doing everything right. And listings just bring in more inquiries. They bring in more calls, bring in more leads. So any agent that's out there right now not focusing on bringing in listings, you're making a mistake. So what I've done, I looked back at the past 20 years I've been doing this and really how I generated a lot of business when I first got started. Because back in the mid-2000s, right, Zillow wasn't a thing, Realtor.com wasn't much of a thing. These online portals that a lot of agents have become overly reliant on didn't exist. And I traced back where most of my listing business was coming from and where my business was coming from in general. And I really found two key areas. One is my sphere, which we've talked about at length. I'm not gonna get into that. And the other is circle dialing and calling into neighborhoods. And this is where the listings were coming from. And it's a lot of hard work. It's sweat equity. And a lot of agents will say, or have a story in their head that goes something like, hey, the likelihood of them selling just doesn't make a lot of sense. Nobody picks up the phone anymore. I don't want to call into those neighborhoods. And yeah, it is hard. It's a lot of heavy lifting when you're calling into neighborhoods looking for business. What I know is we're seeing agents on our team and across the country have great success with this because nobody else wants to do it. And when you do the things that nobody else wants to do, that's when you see significant and positive results. So I broke down for you, and I want to go over this because a lot of people then get worried about what they're going to say on the phone, right? What am I going to say to this person? How's the conversation going to go? And there's really four reasons that you can be calling into these neighborhoods where you want to expand your market share, where you want to be doing more business. So the first and most obvious one is the just listed, just sold call. So ring, ring, ring. Hi, it's Tom here with RE/MAX and the Tom Tool Sales Group. I just sold your neighbor's home over at 123 Main Street. We had 10 offers come in. Only one buyer got it. Who else do you know that's looking to buy or sell a home right now? Or who else do you know that's looking to sell in the neighborhood? That's probably the better question. Really easy phone call, right? You just sold in their neighborhood. You're the most recent expert. You know the buyers that are interested. So that's really effective. So that's the obvious one. And if you're not doing that right now, you're missing a huge opportunity. Now, here's the thing. I find that a just sold call is a lot better than a just listed call because you've got a tangible result. You might say to me, well, Tom, I don't have any sales right now. I don't have any listings that are selling. So here's the second reason. You've got a buyer looking in a specific neighborhood, right? So they want to be in that particular street, this side of the major highway, whatever it is, you know you have buyers that are looking for something very, very specific. That's another great reason to call. So the call goes something like this. Ring, ring, ring. Hi, it's Tom here with RE/MAX and the Tom Tool Sales Group. I'm calling because I've got a buyer who's looking for a home right in your neighborhood, and we haven't been able to find anything. There's no inventory right now, and they're bursting at the seams in their current property. Who do you know in the neighborhood that might be thinking about making a move? Easy phone call. Leverage the client that you have. You're also doing great work for your client by calling into the neighborhoods and reaching out proactively for them. And that's another way you can take your existing business and leverage it into something else. Now, you might say, well, I don't got any buyers that are looking for something specific either. They're kind of all over the place. So here's reason number three. You're hosting an open house in a neighborhood. Now, obviously with pandemic and COVID and all this other stuff, open houses may or may not be something you're comfortable with. At some point, that's going to go away. So very simple. Hey, I'm calling to personally invite you to your neighbor's open house. Please stop by. We're having a neighbor's only open a half hour before we let the public in. We'd love to meet you and show you what the home looks like. Really easy. Open houses have a 10% conversion ratio. You get to meet them face to face. It's really, really easy to close people once you get in front of them. And it's a much softer call, right? You're calling, inviting them somewhere, not asking if they know somebody who's thinking about moving. So that's reason number three. Now here's the last one. And this one is the one that everybody can be doing. Everybody can be doing this. And it's talking about sales activity in the neighborhood, even if you didn't sell the home. Because what you can say is something to the effect of, ring, 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 hi, it's Tom here with RE/MAX and the Tom Tool Sales Group. I'm calling to let you know that your neighbor's home just sold for a record price. They got the highest price ever recorded in your neighborhood. And there's a lot of people that are interested in moving here. So who do you know that's thinking about making a move? Because there's other buyers out there looking to get into your specific neighborhood. Same thing, just give them something of value. And it's really about finding a reason to make the calls and not just mailing it in or being afraid of the phone. And the key here with all of these, asking the question, who do you know? Not are you, not specific, don't give commission breath off. It's who do you know? It's a lot softer of a call. Those four ways of calling into neighborhoods, there will be people this year that learn to dominate the listing side of the business because they take that specific tack that I just broke down for you. Very easy, very simple. This is a way that people have been generating business forever, and 2021 is about back to basics when it comes to listing lead gen. You got any questions? You want to know more? Reach out to me. Otherwise, we'll be back next week.